Thank you all so much for joining us this afternoon. Really excited to share what we're doing at Muzology and what Muzology is. And with everything, I'd like to start with the why. So we're going to show you a short clip where you can hear testimonials from students who have used Muzology. This is why we do what we do.
So on the Muzology videos, when now I'm looking at them and I'm listening, I can use different examples that they talk about and sing on my tests. Because at first I was like, oh, I'm failing. I'm not going to be able to do this. Because it wasn't my type of style of music. But then after a couple of days or weeks, I actually got used to it and I liked it. Like, and then I started telling the teacher, I was like, Miss Foran, I can do this. I'm getting 100% on my test, and you seen it on the screen. I was like, who else got this in this class except for me? Not trying to be overconfident, I was just saying, I was proud of myself because I've never made 100% in that class before. And I was just so proud of myself. Like, I kind of got emotional for a second, and I am now, because I'm just seeing myself. I'm just like, I'm so proud, because I've never felt that feeling before of just getting 100% on my test. And I just feel so proud of myself now. So I just want to thank my teacher, and I want to thank Muzology and the first lady over there for bringing Muzology up and let it go out all through the states or wherever y'all do it at. I just want to thank y'all.
Awesome. And so his teacher that he thanks is actually with us today. I see you right there, Miss Forehand. So happy that you've joined us. And just a point of clarification, the first lady to whom he refers is the first lady of Arkansas. So we've been delighted to do a lot of great work with the administration in Arkansas, and they're really fantastic educators and students. So I'd like to explain why we started Muzology. We started it because we realized that many students struggled with learning, yet these same students knew the words to countless pop songs. And we might ask, well, why is that? That's because music directly activates brain regions that are critical for successful learning. And those brain regions are attention, motivation, memory, and emotion. Now, when we talk to educators such as yourselves about the greatest challenges you face in the classroom today, that's your short list right there. And so in music, you have this medium that really fires on all cylinders, creating a super interactive, high engagement learning experience. So we wondered, what if we assembled a team of hit songwriters, producers, learning experts to create music videos that teach entire subjects? And so let's pause there for a second. If you think about how music is typically used in the context of learning, what you'll realize is that it's limited to early childhood learning, where it's very pervasive. But then after about kindergarten, first grade, music tends to just fall out of the learning process, short of one-off novelty songs. You may remember Schoolhouse Rock, Conjunction Junction, I'm a Bill on Capitol Hill, The Periodic Table, Quadratics, The 50 Nifty United States. But those are all regarded as one-off novelties. They're regarded as kind of like party tricks, not credible pedagogical learning methodologies. And so we said, what if we could do two things? What if we could enlist members of the creative community who are hit songwriters and producers who are writing the type of music that students choose to listen to electively? And two, what if we could show that music actually is a credible pedagogical tool and can be used to teach entire subjects, not just one-off topics here and there, and could also extend beyond rote memorization, which tends to be what's treated in these one-off novelty songs, and instead could be used to teach procedures, skills, and algorithms. And so we started with Pre-Algebra, and the results have been pretty amazing. And so I'd like to showcase a video. Miss Forehand, you didn't know this, but you're gonna be on screen right now. And I'd like to show you a video of what happened within weeks of bringing Muzology to Miss Forehand's classroom. It's about a 6-minute video, but I really would love for you to see it all. So here we go.
I am in our gang, I guess. Most of my family members are well known in gang activities. I lost a couple friends to gun violence and drug abuse.
How does it make you feel as a young man? I mean, is it, does it make you sad? Is it?
It ain't nothing good, but it's, I guess it's life.
He is one that will give up very quickly.
One of my biggest dreams is I want to be a heart surgeon, a cardiothoracic. But if you want to be a doctor, you're supposed to have good grades, not that person of getting good grades.
Perseverance is not something that you see a lot.
I failed this class.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do Muzology today. And this is a new program, and it's where they're putting our math concepts to music.
When she first told us that we was gonna be using music to learn, we all didn't like it because we thought it was gonna be some wannabe rappers.
This table, I need everybody to get an iPad, please. I need phones put away.
Hey there, and welcome to Muzology, a fun, music-based way to get algebra ready. You know how you can easily remember your favorite songs by singing along? Muzology works exactly the same way.
I think it was hard.
I know it's hard. They're advanced level, baby.
I got my first one right.
Watch the music video as many times as you need. Finally, take the math challenges to earn achievements and awards.
That's what it is.
That's it.
Because that was the girl that was singing that part.
That's right.
Because I'm starting to learn stuff. Fraction, decimals. Stuff that I didn't get to learn or didn't get when they taught it. Hey, you gonna come see this cameraman? I'm getting 100 over here.
Look at that, that's a 10 out of 10.
Good job.
You see this? This is brain power. Now tell me, anybody in this class pass blue? I don't think so.
Bam, I'm done! Bam, I'm done!
It made me feel good.
How about what?
Well, do you always make 100% or?
I like how music. It's good. I like music. I like rap, opera, hip hop, pop.
Santis app, I like the tennis.
I know both of y'all. I'm proud of y'all.
Okay, so what are you going to do when you bring home an A?
She going to flip. She going to make it rain.
First time that they've gotten 100% in this class. And I have never seen the smiles on their faces like this. I think that this may be a solution to help them get that confidence and fill in the gaps that they need to be successful. Awesome job. 100.
Yes, ma'am. I feel great about it. I like how I interact with music.
I know I've seen you in the hallway and you'd be bopping down the hallway, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
You like your music, don't you?
Yes, ma'am. I really like it. I think it's a good method of using to remember.
And you know what I saw with you on this one? What does persevere mean?
Meaning that I stuck to it.
When I achieve more, I think Muzology is gonna help with students' grades.
I think I really watched him take that video and that challenge about 10 times because he kept getting 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10, and he was not gonna settle for it until he got his 100%.
Back then, your OG was supposed to provide you with money and drugs and teach you how to do this and that. I feel like school is the OG now. School is gonna teach you how to add, read, write, and carry you to a bigger and better level.
You immediately knew what song that was, and you knew the lyrics. That's the reason why we created Muzology.
You, the First Lady of Arkansas, First Lady Susan Hutchinson.
Yeah! And
Dr. Israel said that she had figured a way to use music directly to help all students.
Music is very, very special. It opens up the world to you when you learn.
And you all are doing it, and you're going to continue to do it. And we're really, really proud of you.
If I better myself, I feel like I can better everybody around me. That's how a movement can start, really.
Thank you so much for taking the time to watch that with me. Can you all hear me okay still?
Yes.
Okay, fantastic, fantastic. You know, those comments were spot on, the comments about the smiles on the students' faces, their confidence. If possible, Kerr, is there any way that we can turn on Shirley Forehand's Mike, I didn't realize she'd be here with us today, and I'd love her just to be able to comment quickly about this experience.
Yeah, I was able to make both Connie and Shirley co-hosts, so they can unmute themselves if they want.
Okay, fantastic. Shirley, why don't you, if you don't mind, why don't you jump in and share a little bit about your Muzology experience? And Connie, I'm going to show some data and some videos, and then maybe after that, you can jump in. How's that sound?
Sounds good.
Fantastic.
Yes. One of the things that I found with my students was the eagerness that they were wanting to do this. I teach 9th and 10th grade and was a little hesitant at first, but they jumped right in, and the 100% that they were getting all the time was just incredible. You saw their faces, you saw them light up, and these are students that were coming to me literally functioning on a third, maybe fourth grade level, if I was lucky.
Okay. Thank you so much, Shirley. Really appreciate that. You know, it's really important what we're talking about here, because something unexpected happened when we started Muzology, and I see the comments about the power of music, and that's exactly right. And Karen, your comment is what I'm about to talk about. So, you know, we understood intellectually that music has this intrinsic mnemonic and learning power and property, and so that's why we started Muzology. We expected to see academic results. We didn't expect them to see them to the degree I'm now about to show you. But what we didn't realize is what would start to happen to these students at the level of self-efficacy and self-confidence. And so exactly as Karen just pointed out in the comments, was obvious they probably hadn't experienced much school success. You know, what happens to these learners is they get stuck in this negative self-reinforcing feedback loop, where something enters their mind. It could be something a teacher said, it could be something they internalized, a parent said, a friend said, and they have this limiting belief, I'm dumb, I'm bad at math, I hate math, math is hard. And we all know students who think and feel that way. And so once that's their reality, they check out. So they don't pay attention, they act up, they don't study, and so they get another bad grade, which reconfirms their belief that they're bad at math and all those other things, and they're stuck in the spiral. And what happens with Muzology is these kids go, wait, music videos? That's okay to learn that. And they watch these videos and they're kind of intrigued because we're talking their language, we're meeting them where they live, we're presenting stuff to them on their own terms, it's engaging. And suddenly they take quizzes after watching the videos, and for the first time in their lives, they're getting 80s, 90s, 100s. As someone pointed out, look at the smiles on those kids' faces in Ms. Forehand's class when they were getting the first 100% of their life in math. And what happens is that feedback loop gets stopped in its tracks and starts to spin around this way. Suddenly these kids go, wait a second, maybe I can do this. Maybe, you know, maybe math's not so hard. It's actually kind of fun. It actually feels good to excel. It actually feels good to achieve. Because the secret is every kid wants to experience success and achievement and feel great about themselves. And when they do, they want more of it. And that's what starts to happen. And I saw some of those comments earlier about you start to experience that success, and success begets success. And now they're paying attention more. And now they're applying themselves. And now they're interested in math. And it's a really, it builds their self-esteem, 100%, Jennifer. And it's a really beautiful thing that happens. So given that we have math teachers here, I'd love to show you some numbers and data. I'm just gonna highlight some key findings and studies. Starting with a small-scale randomized control trial that we conducted in Knoxville, Tennessee. And Connie teaches in Knoxville, and it's great to have you with us. Connie, like Ms. Forehand, is one of our high engagement Muzology superstar teachers. So it is always lovely to see both of you. And we conducted this pilot, not at Connie's school, but at another school in Knoxville, with underperforming entering sixth graders. This was an urban middle school. And we were asked to prove the methodology by teaching them a gateway bottleneck topic in math. Why don't you try to guess what it is? Let's see. Anybody have an idea? Fractions, that's right. Fraction, Karen, you're on it. It was actually fractions, and one of the videos was converting fractions into decimals. So right on. So we taught these students fractions. We had three videos that did so in song form, and I'm gonna demonstrate and show you one of our videos momentarily. You'll see that we've got talent on screen, we've got motion graphics. And so three videos taught students basic terms related to fractions, numerator, denominator, mixed number, common denominator, equivalent fractions, all four operations of fractions, and then how to convert fractions into decimals. The control group saw the same talent present the same information conversationally with the same graphic overlays. So we controlled for music versus no music. Exposure to the materials was held constant between conditions, and students were randomly assigned to the Muzology or control group, blocked by performance on a pretest diagnostic. We worked with a research professor at University of Tennessee, Knoxville. He did all the random assignment and data analysis, so that all happened at arm's length. I'm gonna show you what happened when students were tested after a 3-day delay and a 7-day delay. So this means they had no exposure to the information, and I might point out this is new information. They hadn't learned this before, but they had no exposure to the information for 3 days. We see an increase in performance in the control group, which is great. We see greater statistically significant improvement in the Muzology group. Now, what we're really interested to see is what happens after 7 days, because this study falls very squarely into a body of research called recall after learning. And what those studies show is that if you're learning something new and you don't have enough exposure to it, or repetition or rehearsal for it to transfer into long-term memory, which were the conditions of this study, because students over the course of a week had exposure to the videos for less than an hour, and a lot of content was covered. What happens is, in those conditions, you typically see a little spike in retention in 24 to 72 hours after last exposure, when the brain consolidates the information. And then after 72 hours, you typically see a drop in retention. Actually, you always see it. All that differs from study to study is how precipitous that drop is. So it's exactly what happened in the control group. So much so that the student's teacher saw this, and he said to me, "This is like I taught my students something last week, and this week they've already forgotten it." And we were hoping for a less precipitous drop in the Muzology group, and that's what happened. So an interesting finding that kind of flies in the face of contemporary understanding of how recall after learning is supposed to work. On the basis of these data, we then built out a beta version of the Muzology platform that we were fortunate enough to pilot also with Knox County Schools in their Summer Bridge program. This is a program for students who failed eighth grade math. This is data from about 300 students. Students took a pretest before unlocking a Muzology video. Here's the distribution of scores on that pretest. As you can see, it's a normal distribution with a tail towards the higher performing scores. And the mode is a 30%. So these kids aren't kind of not getting it, they're really not getting it. They pretest, they watch a Muzology video. The first time they post-test again, I'd like some of you to guess, what do you think the mode becomes the first time they post-test? So 30% on the pretest, 70, 60, 50, 80, 80, 50, 80, 50, 65, Great. These are usually the responses we get. And this is what happened. The mode becomes 100%. We've replicated this finding in every state. Yeah, it is a wild Tamara. It's an amazing finding. It's a really amazing finding. And we've replicated it in every state, district, school, classroom that uses Muzology, irrespective of anything you can think of, title versus non-title school, honors class versus intervention, special ed, general instruction, everywhere we go, we obtain that same distribution. And what's amazing about that distribution is, like, if we showed this blue distribution to a statistician and said, tell us what you think it characterizes, they would probably never guess a human trait or characteristic, because we've all been taught that every human trait and characteristic, from height in the population to IQ scores to standardized test scores, is characterized by a bell-shaped curve. So here again, we obtain a finding that kind of flies in the face of contemporary understanding of how memory works, or quote unquote, distributed human properties work. Finally, I want to show you data from a district diagnostic. This was also in a summer school program. At the beginning of the program, 3% of students passed the district diagnostic. This is a comprehensive diagnostic. Yes, please show your statistician. I love that. Let me know what your statistician says. Karen has great comments in there. So 3% of students pass the diagnostic before using Muzology. 4 weeks later, 1 in 3 students pass a comprehensive diagnostic. These are students who failed math during the school year, and we see incredible gains. Now, I must point out, these are correlative data. The first set of data we showed you from the RCT are data that allows us to make causal attributions. But I think we see here pretty impressive gains amongst a population of students that were really struggling with the content in a very short amount of time. So we've seen that Muzology works. We are very grateful to the National Science Foundation, from whom we've received 2 grants to date, and it's been a real joy and pleasure to work with them. And also, we're honored to be named a top innovative education technology company in the country by the National School Boards Association in 2018. Can everybody hear me okay? I see there's a comment about volume.
Yeah, I was just noticing that. For me, it's the same, but I'm not sure.
Okay. Yet. Okay. Good. And in terms of the comment about Spanish language songs, that is something we are absolutely wanting to do. I'm so happy to see those comments showing up here. I'm just going to show you a little snippet from a couple of our songs. So it's kind of sometimes hard to imagine what we do. So I'd like you to get to see it.
Left and right, X up and down, Y. Left and right, X up and down, Y. Left and right, X up and down, Y. Reference lines on which you rely. The space where you grab points has a long name. It's called Cartesian coordinate plane. This coordinate plane comes to be when you draw the X and Y axis. Coordinate plane, like an old school map. 2 coordinates pinpoint exactly where you're at. In ordered pairs, comma Y in parentheses moves the point horizontally then vertically. X coordinate moves across left, right. Y moves up, down, up, down.
Unite.
Coordinate supports to show an exact position. You need to know the X, the Y, when graphing's the mission. Left and right, X up and down, Y. Left and right, X up and down, Y. Left and right, X up and down, Y. Reference lines on which you rely.
X axis and Y axis make 4 quadrants. And in this you plot coordinates to find out where a point is. Using an ordered pair. Using an ordered pair.
To graph points, everything is relative to the origin. Think of it like a starting point where you should be.
On a 2D graph, 0, 0 are coordinates that mark the spot. Origins where X and Y
numbers to the left as you go. Positive numbers.
Stop that there. Really great questions coming in during the song, Denise. I'm happy to see you've already signed up and you're using Muzology. So to answer the question, Muzology is currently being offered free for any students, teachers, parents affected by COVID-19 school closures, and will be certainly through mid-June, and we may even extend that. I did see someone ask about pricing earlier, and you can feel free to reach out to info@muzology.com. Pricing is just tiered based upon number of students in the school, but we can get back to you on that. In terms of questions about how many times students should watch a video, just like we all remember the words to our like favorite pop songs or songs we hear on the radio, that happens after repetition. And so what's really fascinating about music is like if you hear a song that you hadn't heard since you were, let's say, 12 years old, all the words come back to you decades later. That's an amazing phenomenon if you think about it. There's probably very few other things, if any other thing you can think about that you like got exposed to when you were a teenager, and decades later, you can recall all the information verbatim. So like if I were to say to you, hey, recall verbatim a lesson that your math teacher gave you in middle school, you'd laugh at me and tell me that's a preposterous question. But if I were to say like, hey, tell me verbatim the words to your favorite song in middle school, you'd be like, that's a silly question. Of course I can do it. And so that's what's so amazing about the power of music. But that happens through repetition, or rather, and that happens through repetition. So there's not a magic number. We like to say at least three times. The reality is the more students watch these videos, the more the information sinks in. What we also see, and I think the teachers can attest to this, you know, sometimes the first time students are watching the video, they're attending to more of like the novelty features, like, oh, do I like the singer? What are they wearing? How are they dancing? Is he cute? Is she cute? What, I mean, like, you know, stuff like that. And after they watch the first time, the second time, they've gotten over the novelty features, and now they're kind of attending to, all right, what are the big ideas I'm being taught? And then the third time they watch, they're going, okay, now let me absorb the detail. But the reality is some students will need or want to watch it more times than others, but we like three as a baseline. What you're also able to do with Muzology is play videos in the context of in school learning, at the class level or the individual level. The way the platform works is every student has their own login. And so, and every video has three associated quizzes, silver, gold, and blue, and they earn silver, gold, and blue records as they progress through the platform. Connie, do you want to jump in now and maybe share your experience, and I'll show a little bit from another Muzology video and we'll continue going.
Okay. I put some things in the comments too, because I don't know if they saw me, but I was bouncing along and singing some of the words, because that repetition comes within the songs too. And you'll see the kids do that as they watch the videos. And even in they're taking a test or doing an assignment afterwards, I'll have kids, you can see them going in their head and singing the song. So it's really awesome how it gets into their head. I had kids get up and dance to it last year. So they enjoy it. And I challenge them, like my honors, I say they go to the gold record. You just mentioned there's three records. My on level, I tell them the silver, but I just challenge them to go to the next level or higher. And then I have a lot of kids going ahead and trying to do that to get some extra credit.
That's awesome. You know, Connie, you brought up something really interesting. And I saw in the comments, someone was talking about the colors. Everything we do in our videos is intentional. Learning theory drives everything we create. Sometimes, you know, it's evident to people, and sometimes it's just, hey, that, you know, the video seems engaging and kids are learning why. But we color code things within and between videos. As Connie was explaining, their dance moves. We have choreographed dance moves that were possible reinforces the information students are learning. So there's a kinesthetic component to this that really connects to the information. And so this becomes this very multimodal learning experience for students where we're reinforcing the same information using different modalities at the same time.
And let me add, I just saw someone asked a comment about assigning. You don't go through a certain path. You can assign whichever video you want, one at a time or two at a time, for an extended period of time. I mean, you can start them in class, but they can do it at home also.
That's so great.
It's a great way to differentiate for your students.
So any questions, data protection and stuff like that, if you just contact us at info@muzology.com, we can answer all those questions. I'll show you just a little bit from another video, and then I'd love to be able to just jump onto the platform and show you all what it looks like. As Connie was saying, there's an assignment feature right in the platform, which enables you to assign single or multiple music videos to groups of students, individual students, entire classes. So just show you a little bit of a two-step equation video.
When you're solving equations, the typical situation is there is just one solution. Yeah, there's just one solution. But there are two special cases where this outcome changes. An unexpected conclusion that becomes your solution. Sometimes you'll find that there will be no solution. Sometimes there will be infinitely many solutions. When your equation has no solution, all your variables cancel, and you're left with the false statement. Yeah. Oh yeah. All your variables cancel, and you're left with the false statement. This means that no values can satisfy your equation. No solution. Statement. When you have infinitely many solutions, all your variables cancel and you're left with the true statement. Yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. All your variables cancel and you're left with the true statement. Yeah. Any and all values can satisfy your equation. Infinitely many true statement. Infinitely many true statement. No solution. False statement. Infinitely many true statement. No solution. False statement. Infinitely many true statement.
So I recognize that I just showed you a few videos with all male performers, and did just want to point out that we are very conscious of having male, female artists at different backgrounds in all of the videos. That just happens to be the case with the two I showed you right now. And there was a really interesting comment. Muzology is a great warm-up. It's also a great refresher. And you know, who knows where we're going to be the beginning of the next school year with having to quickly refresh gaps given what's going on right now. And so, before COVID, 19, a lot of teachers said when students came into their math class, even algebra, they would use it coming out of summer slide as a really fun, engaging, quick way to refresh like everything students learned in pre-algebra. So it's great for intervention and remediation, absolutely. It's a great refresher. And Connie was explaining, Muzology works with a three-step method. Students answer five warm-up questions to unlock a music video, and I'll show you that in a moment. What that does is it primes the student for what they're about to learn, it activates pre-existing knowledge, and it gives you and the student like a gross baseline measure of what they knew coming into the video. I'm just gonna have a sip of water quickly. So the difference between Muzology and Flocabulary, vocabulary tends to be exclusively rap, Their coverage of pre-algebra, I don't think, is as deep as Muzology's. They have much broader coverage across multiple math topics. We really focus on pre-algebra. And we take different approaches to kind of the musical styles we use. A lot of their videos tend to be animated. We use live people singing and dancing. Motion graphics are kind of different, but happy to talk more about some of those differences. You know, from our perspective, anytime you're bringing music into the classroom, be it vocabulary or musology, it's a great engaging thing for students. So we're happy to see any and all music-based solutions being used to help students learn in the classroom. I was going to give you a little bit about my background, but you know what? I'd rather just jump into the platform and get to show you a little bit of this. Just really, really quickly, the reason that I started Muzology was based on an innate fascination with learning at a young age, and I started researching the brain and the mind in eighth grade. That was my eighth grade science project on a learning technique called mind mapping. That led me to Australia. That's why there's a koala bear on the screen, if you were wondering. And I got invited to speak at a global education conference in Sydney when I was 14 years old. And within a day of arriving in Australia, appeared on a show called The Ray Martin Show, and they referred to him as the Johnny Carson of Australia. That's why Johnny Carson's on the screen. And within a couple of weeks of being in Australia, I had a book publishing deal for a little book that I just kind of wrote as a handout for the presentation I was giving. Wound up getting published in Australia and distributed ultimately all over the world. And so the work I did with mind mapping led me to South Korea, Good Morning America. I created a lot of multimedia content on learning. That's me in 12th grade. That's a five-year study on learning that I conducted that won the grand award at the International Science and Engineering Fair. And what I learned through all of that, which really kind of led up to Muzology, was the importance of active learning. And we've seen students who, you know, they're in class, they take notes, and they kind of look down at the page, and they've got a full page of writing, and they go, did I actually write this? I don't even remember writing any of it, but it's on my page. And so that's how I used to study before mind mapping. And so for me, studying was, first you took your notes, that wasn't studying. And then you went and taking notes was really copying your textbook in your own handwriting, in your notebook. And then you read the notes, and that was studying. And when I started working with mind mapping, which is a visuospatial way of documenting information, I realized that what was going on and why we were getting such great results with it is it turned learning from a passive to an active process. I think active learning is of critical importance in this day and age when we're competing with these devices all the time. And really what music does, I think music is this evolution from active learning to what I call intra-active learning, I-N-T-R-A, intra-active learning. Because what happens with music is you learn without even trying. For example, if during this presentation we were playing a song on repeat the whole time, I can assure you that when this presentation ended, even if you were attending to me, when the presentation ended, you'd start singing some of the words from the song. And that's just how powerful music is. So I think it's a really amazing approach to learning. After doing my doctoral work in England, I wound up moving to Manhattan and working in the music business, and had the good fortune of working with the artists you see on the screen. And that's when I had a eureka moment and realized that, wait a second, you know, there's really nothing more powerful than music in the context of learning. And that's kind of what started Muzology. These are thank you notes from Mrs. Forehand's students. They're really amazing. I love them all, but you know, this one in particular on the left, which is, you know, before I knew about Muzology, I couldn't solve anything that had to do with fractions. Now I can multiply, divide, add, and subtract. Thank you for your help in the catchy songs. And some other comments from students that have been really wonderful to receive. So here is some. I know I was actually looking at a clock that was incorrect, and now I see we have 2 minutes left. So here's my personal contact information, and I'd be delighted for anybody to reach out to me with any questions, additional questions you may have. You can reach out to info@muzology.com as well. Thank you, Allison. You can follow us on socials at Muzology EDU. And let me just see really quickly. Do y'all see that?
Yes.
Okay, great. This is the Muzology platform, your homepage. This is the assignment that the teacher recently assigned, recently watched videos. Here you can see how your students are doing. There's a video library here where you can see videos grouped by topics. Our videos are creative, our video titles are not. Our video titles tell you what the videos are about. Here's the teacher's playlist, and this is where you can create a playlist really quickly. Integers. I'm just gonna click and put these things in it for now. I can assign it now or later. I'm gonna assign it now. I'm gonna assign it to all of my classes. I'm gonna hit next. I can enter a start or due date, an optional message. I'll just enter a due date. Assign. And there you go. Your playlist is assigned. You can edit it by moving videos around. The playlist. Apart from clicking here, here we go. Just drag your videos around. The computer's not clicking so well here. But that's real easy to use Muzology. Analytics section where you can look at performance at the class level, individual students. There are lots of ways of slicing and dicing the data. You earn teacher records based on the number of students who earn a record on a challenge. This is also a way of really grasping how your students are doing. And then the My Students section is really your class roster management section of the website. And then there's a Getting Started section, which gives you some resources, including this Quick Start, which will show you the key things you need to know to start using Muzology. Finally, just wanted to mention to you all, this is something we're really proud of. We applied our methodology to maybe one of the most pressing things going on for all of us right now when it comes to education, and that is learning about COVID-19, the coronavirus. We work with some amazing artists who have worked with people like Beyonce and Camila Cabello and Lizzo. Also in this video is Chris Blue, season 12 winner of The Voice. And if you have a chance, we'd love for you to watch it. You can find it on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. It's called All Over the Map, the Coronavirus Song. And it's a video that we created to help educate people about some really important things that are helpful to know about COVID-19. So if you have a chance, please check it out. In terms of, I saw a question, a couple questions that came up before. Students don't need a Muzology account. I mean, a teacher can get an account and just do things at the class level, but we don't really recommend that as the best use case. You really want students to be able to log in, progress through the videos at their pace, take the challenges. Oh, I didn't show you the challenges. But there are three challenges, as mentioned, attached to every music video. And the first challenge, it tends to consist of exclusively multiple choice questions and is pretty, you know, establishes basic understanding of the information. Students have to get 100% to level up to the goal challenge, which establishes proficiency and consists of multiple choice, multiple select, and some free response questions. And when they get 100 on that, they level up to the blue challenge, which tends to be exclusively free response and extending the information beyond what they learned in the video. So to really get that experience and to experience the gamification and see their own progress, student accounts are required. And that's the use case we would recommend. The age range is essentially, it tends to be, depending on the student's level and your state and your pacing, anywhere from 5th to 9th grade. We do focus on pre-algebra and algebra readiness, so that's kind of the sweet spot of what Muzology covers. You could just Connie, you were explaining the class codes. Mm-hmm. We do sync with Google Classroom right now with the free accounts. I don't know if Google Classroom is enabled, but for any kind of paid subscribers to Muzology, we support Google Classroom. We integrate with Canvas, a lot of other LMSs. So we work closely with districts and schools to make sure we can support any single sign-on rostering systems that you use. Yay, Chris Blue from Knoxville. That's right. He's an amazing person. One of the most talented people we've had the pleasure to work with. Thanks to Allison, who's in this on the session right now, who introduced us to Chris. The songs, do they only explain procedures or formal algorithms? They go beyond that too. In many cases, we'll show examples or application of the information. So for example, our song on the Pythagorean theorem, we show how to determine a missing side's length. We also show you how to apply it to determine if a triangle is a right triangle. Our song on square roots shows you how to estimate and approximate imperfect squares. It explains what they are. So we go beyond procedures and skills wherever we can.
I like you added
the name of the Corona too. Song. It's called All Over the Map, in parentheses, the coronavirus song. And if you search for either of those terms on YouTube, it's coming up pretty high now. So, and it's a real colorful thumbnail, and you'll see that it's from Muzology. We'd love for you to watch it and share it with anyone you think might be able to benefit from it. Well, we love mid-school math, so I love that comment where we'll have to talk to Scott about that. Let's see, other questions? No, Lori, there's no specific platform that this should be run on. Just really any device that's connected to the internet. So it runs on, any kind of desktop, laptop, computer. Chromebooks as well, we get asked about a lot. Runs great on Chromebooks, runs great on any tablet you're using. You can use it on mobile. We don't have a native mobile app, so you're just accessing the website on mobile. Some features are better experienced on a tablet or laptop than mobile, but students can use it across any device. That's right, it's not enabled for Google Classroom for the free accounts currently. But for paid accounts, we support that integration. Unfortunately, the question about internet, the songs aren't downloadable at present. I can tell you we've been having some really interesting conversations about potentially broadcasting this content on radio or public broadcasting, and we really hope we're able to do something like that to support students who may not have devices and or internet connections. Allison, thank you for sharing the YouTube link to the video. Do you use the song to intro concept? We see some teachers do that, and other teachers like to do it the other way around. Looking forward to hearing from you, Lori. Mr. Forster, we're looking to expand, yes, at the pre-algebra level and beyond. We're looking to augment our current pre-algebra offering and also address algebra and then probably elementary school math as well. Oh yeah, if you want to, do you want me to play all over the map? Someone recommended doing that. I'm happy to do that. If you signed up for an account and you didn't get an email, just check your spam. If not, just could you please email us at either info@muzology.com or support@muzology.com, and we'll take care of that right away. Denise, we're hoping to add more to geometry. Exactly, the expansion of pre-algebra would probably consist of more geometry, pre-algebra, and statistics and probability. My email again, you're asking for my email is lana@muzology.com. I'm just going to type it in the comments. That's my email. You can follow us socials here, and then we're just muzology.com. All right, let's play all over the map. Great, we've got a couple minutes to do it. Thank you all. It's been so much fun to get to do this. I think it's kind of more fun than an in-person conference because it's so nice to see all the comments real time. And we appreciate you all being here today. Please check out Muzology, give it a try. Reach out to us anytime you have questions. I think Connie and Shirley can both attest to the fact that we love hearing from teachers and students. We're very responsive. We love hearing feedback about things we can do to improve your experience. And so we're here to support you and your students' learning and always love to have bi-directional communication with everybody. So let me share my screen again and we'll play the video.
Yay.
There's a new novel virus they call the corona.
It's through the air, sticks to things like your phone.
If you touch your face, your mouth, your nose, or your iris,
with the germs on your hands, you can get the virus.
Corona germs can live on surfaces of things, tables, handles, countertops, car keys, and playground swings. If someone sick is next to you, they cross spit, talk, or board you. These are other ways that you could get the sickness too.
May not even know it.
Yeah.
It could take a week or two for you to show it. That's the reason in this season you should have a little patience. So stay at home, cause anyone could be contagious. Don't go to public places, stay away from the crowd, cause now is not the time that you should be going out. Feel a tossing body aches, so feeling short of breath.
Corona's not the wanna catch.
Apart when we're together, alone but not forever. Stay at home, keep your distance for a while, cause this is all over the map. Over the map. Don't hurt, high five or shake your hand, not a mistake.
All over the place,
all over the place,
over the place,
all over the place.
Run, scrub, wash your hands, stay at home just in case.
This is how we wash our hands.
What? Your hands with running water, use some soap to lather. Wash the front and wash the back and do it with some swagger.
Clean your hands between your fingers and above your wrists.
Fingertips and fingernails, you do the Turkish twist.
Don't forget your thumbs, they're important too. Count for 20 seconds, nothing less to do. You can pass the time by singing a tune like
happy birthday to you.
When your hands are nice and clean, don't touch the dirty tab. Use your elbow, arm, or paper towel so the germs don't ever come back.
The virus can hit anyone, but it's riskier for some.
If you contract it, call up your doc.
Call up your doc.
If you do it for the gram, you can do it for the gram. Don't be selfish, stay home. Young, you're old, listen up, understand. No cap, coronavirus is
all over the map.